This tiny teach is going to be about transformation, one of the three methods of genetic recombination in bacteria. Transformation is transfer and integration of DNA fragments from dead, lysed donor bacterium to a recipient bacterium. And it was discovered by Frederick Griffith back in 1928. Griffith's lab studied the bacteria Streptococcus pneumoniae. It is one of the causes of pneumonia. And pneumonia at the time was quite dangerous because there was no antibiotics available. Griffith's lab had two strains of Streptococcus pneumoniae, what they called an S or smooth strain. If you saw colonies of the bacteria growing on an agar plate, they would look smooth to the naked eye. And this strain of bacteria produced a capsule, and what they called the R or rough strain. If you saw colonies of this bacteria growing on an agar plate, they looked rough to the naked eye. And this particular strain of bacteria did not cause a capsule. Griffith did some very simple introductory experiments. He took living S strain bacteria, injected them into mice. The mice got pneumonia and they died. He took R strain bacteria, injected them into mice, and the mice did not get pneumonia and they did not die. The difference was that the S strain had a capsule, and the R strain did not have a capsule. So this gave Griffith another idea for an experiment. What if I took the S strain, but I heat killed them? Because capsules are mostly made of protein, by heating the bacteria, he would actually destroy the bacteria and the capsule as well. So he took heat killed S strain and injected them into mice, and the mice did not get pneumonia and they did not die. Then he thought about it a little bit and he designed a very important experiment. He took R strain bacteria that don't cause pneumonia, and he took heat-killed S strain bacteria that don't cause pneumonia, and he injected them into mice. But interestingly, the mice actually got pneumonia and they died. So neither of the things that he injected the mice with caused pneumonia, but somehow the mice ended up with pneumonia. When he cultured the bacteria from the dead mice, he found living S strain. He never gave them living S strain. He gave them heat-killed S strain and R strain. So Griffith wrote a paper hypothesizing that something transformed the living R strain into living S strain. And he was hopeful if he published the paper that somebody else would figure out what the transforming factor was. And Avery, McLeod, and McCarty determined that the transforming factor was DNA. So our heat-treated S strain becomes the donor bacterium. It dies, it releases its DNA into the environment, and the R strain picks up some of the heat-killed S strain's DNA, specifically the gene to make a capsule, and it adds it into its own DNA. So in transformation, the donor bacterium would be our heat killed S strain. It died and it released its DNA fragments into the environment. The recipient bacterium would be the R strain. It's what's known as a competent bacteria. It's able to take up DNA fragments from its environment. In this case, it's picking up the gene for how to make a capsule and adding it into its own DNA. To be a competent bacteria, meaning you're able to take up DNA from your environment, that's not an easy task. Less than 1% of all bacteria are competent. And this now is a S strain bacteria because it has the gene to produce a capsule. So transformation is transfer and integration of DNA fragments from a dead, lysed donor bacterium into a recipient bacterium.